white Bjork because the parking needed a sweeping. And when we moved it, I noticed that there are a pair of keys, probably his house keys, still left in the driver's seat. I figured he might want to know about it. At least his spare key card was not in the car, so hopefully he has it safely locked away at home. Was he ever going to move the car? It's been standing there for almost 2 weeks now.
Thank you. Svante. It's Ingrid. Of course, you're not picking up. But you should know I don't give up easily. Can I pick you up on my way to work tomorrow morning? You know it's not safe for you to keep driving in your condition. But we need to talk about this whole thing again. I can't let you go through with it. You, of all people, should know it goes against any proven scientific protocol. It's unethical, and even your motivations, well... I shouldn't be doing this over a message. Just think about it, please.
July 1989. The other day I was at the hospital in Stockholm for the test results. Pneumonia, which in my condition can be lethal, they said. The medication would bring me a bit of relief, but not much else. We didn't discuss how long I have left. We didn't need to. Can't say it came as a shock. I had plenty of time to get used to the idea. Up with some crazy thoughts this morning. I would be the test subject for the invasive procedure. This disease has already suppressed my immune system anyway, so it should trigger a cytokine release. And using Veronica's algorithm, we could start transcoding the neurosignals immediately. With human coordinated signal cases, we could move ahead at 100 times the speed we can with rats and monkeys. Maybe we could even call the cells infected by HIV directly and... No, I can't let fear drive me. They would never let me do it, and they would be right. August 5th, 1981. Met with Holberg today. Upon his request, we met here at my home and not in the office. He revealed that the National Defense Research Institute has had another top secret program. Its code name is Accounting Office East, or RE, and it's conveniently placed close to here. Hardly a coincidence, but he wouldn't say where. They've been working on prototyping unmanned military machinery in the event of biological or chemical weapons being used. I guess that holds Sverdlovsky Fed Intel matters. He called it the SM program, Combat Machines, and that's where my team comes in. He said, we are to cooperate with RE and find a way to integrate our neural links to the machines. That way a bunker station pilot could control one of these machines without interface. Can't help feeling a bit manipulated. Of course I knew they want to use our research for military purposes, but I always assumed it was for intelligence, counter-espionage, not actual weapons.
Thank you.